There we go.
As the U.S. throws open the doors,
this comeback is ahead of schedule.
And as Canadians eye a cautious summer return, there's still no plan to reopen the border, closed for more than a year.
If one person in Canada was fully vaccinated, that person should be able to cross the border.
New York Congressman Brian Higgins has had enough. He wants both countries to allow access for the fully vaccinated and believes Canada needs to ditch its strict quarantine requirements.
So all of those protocols that were put in place in the absence of vaccines, to me, are no longer relevant.
Neither the Trudeau government nor the Biden administration is ready for that. Canadian officials have said they want at least 75% of the population to receive one dose of vaccine before seriously relaxing domestic restrictions.
The whole issue of opening up the border with the United States, I think obviously it's a very live issue. From a technical public health perspective, we're certainly looking at the data.
Add to that pressure from premiers like Ontario's Doug Ford.
This is why I continue to call on the federal government to do more to secure our borders.
Who blames travelers for the arrival of more contagious virus variants. The border is now so politically sensitive that neither government is willing to set reopening targets or expectations.
We are certainly always assessing as it relates to travel, borders, etc., what we need to do and keep in place in order to keep the American people safe.
All that uncertainty has led to calls for some kind of clarity now.
People need to at least have some sense as to what criteria are going to be used, even if they don't know the exact dates.
So that Canadians and Americans know what it will take to eventually get back together.
With most cross-border trade still flowing freely, talk of reopening the border has become more of a public health calculation. And with virus-weary residents on both sides of the border, that makes it a much more sensitive subject.